We're here in Jakarta Bay, Indonesia, and I'm standing here where we can see, obviously, plastic near the water that will end up going into the ocean.
Once it goes in the water, the truth of the matter is that's a cleanup effort, not a recycling effort. That material in the water is very hard to recycle. The salt and the sun degrades it. We need to catch it before and get it to a level of purity so it can be properly processed by industry in a real and substantial way.
And what we can see here is plastic, but that's very near the irrigation. Some of that plastic is being lit on fire, as you can see the scorched earth. It makes its way into the irrigation and impacts the production of the local crops.
What we're looking to do is find better solutions, especially recycling solutions, that allow waste to be collected and not make its way into irrigation, crops, food chain, and the ocean. We are working on preventing ocean plastics. We sort individual colors, we sort individual streams, we make sure that we monetize the different types of plastic so local community collection can happen.
The secret to recycling is that anything that is mixed together cannot be recycled.
Anything that is effectively sorted can be recycled. So if you have colors together, if you have different types of plastics that are separated and then grouped together, you can prevent ocean plastics. And this happens by paying local community collectors, by bringing recycled content from prevented ocean plastics into our supply chain, as opposed to producing plastic from new plastic made from oil and petrochemicals. Why do we need to add new plastic to the world when all of these hands are working to prevent ocean plastics and give it a new life through proper recycling?